verses.
Gracious Heavenly Father, Father in heaven, we stand here because of Jesus and what he has done for us at your command, as offering a sacrifice made on our behalf. We can stand here washed and cleansed. We thank you, Father in heaven. And we pray that these few minutes will be filled with praise and honor and glory that's only thine. Thank you, Father in heaven. Be with us now, in Jesus' name, amen. This is
the young ones from the Young at Heart care to join us. Please feel free.
Thank you.
Hello. Hey. How are you guys? Great. That's good. Okay. I'm going to tell you a story about a lion and a mouse. That's true. So one day, there was a little mouse in the woods, and he had to hide because he could be eaten by the big lion. And there were bushes all around that he could scurry around, but near the lion's cave, there weren't any bushes. And the little mouse was always told by his mother to stay away from the lion's cave, because he could easily be caught and eaten. But one day, the little mouse strayed a little too far away from the cover of the bushes, and he went over near the lion's cave, and the lion saw his perfect chance. So he pounced out, and he caught the mouse. And the mouse says, "No, please, let me go. I promise I'll help you in the future." And the lion just laughed at him, and he said, "Oh, well, what could a little mouse do for me? But fine, you're too small, you're so young. I'll let you go." Well, many, many years later, there were hunters that came into the woods, and they set up a bunch of traps. And the lion got stuck in one of them, and he was caught in a net, and he didn't know what to do. And he just hung there upside down. He was trapped in this net, and he couldn't get out. He struggled and he struggled. And then finally, he just gave up. He was too tired. He was exhausted. And the little mouse had grown up into a big mouse by then. And he wandered up on the lion, and the lion said, "Please help me out of here, help. I can't get out." And so the little mouse climbed up on the ropes and chewed through all of them, and the lion got out. So then the lion and the mouse became friends, and the lion was very grateful that he didn't eat the mouse. And this, no matter how small or young you are, you can always help someone. You guys can go back to your seats.
Morning. Welcome. I want our visitors to realize that this is not a typical Sabbath. We're having a treat today. The Central Valley Christian Academy, what do you have, band and choir and music department is enhancing our worship service. And so we will have a different type of service from the usual, but we're glad you're here today, whether you're a visitor. I guess we have a lot of visiting musicians, but visitor or member or someone who just, well, what other category is there? A couple announcements to make. If you are a visitor, even if you're not a visitor, we have food available after the meal. We call it potluck or fellowship or whatever you want. But you're welcome to stay and add to your fellowship by getting better acquainted. We have one transfer of membership reading. The first reading, we'll vote it next week. Tim and Lori Sayer from Auburn Church in Auburn, California, just down the road a ways. One other important announcement. We have a business meeting that was scheduled for a week from next Thursday. That's been changed. It is now a week from next Monday. So the business meeting will be on Monday night, May 1, 6:30 p.m. The conference will come and bring us names of our potential pastors. We're looking for a pastor. They will have names. They've done the vetting, the interviewing, and they'll present us, you might call, first draft. So we invite you to be here to have your say and hear what they announce. The offering today is for our local conference, the Nevada-Utah Conference. The conference covers a variety of things. On your tithe envelope, which is in the rack in front of you, it explains the Nevada-Utah Conference advance goes for evangelism, education endowment, building projects. We've benefited from that, and we help other churches and schools benefit. So as we give offerings, as we return tithe, let's remember the conference also helps us work together with our sister churches. Will the deacons please come forward? Let's pray. Father in heaven, thank you for the blessings you give us to share, whether spiritual blessings, financial ones, friendship. As we give today, may our hearts follow our offerings. May we help your work spread in this conference and around the world. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
Start choirs coming into the
However, I firmly believe that a choir should never be limited in number, so you want to choir over. We'll be singing a couple of hymns together. Some of them you may not know. They just learned them a few months ago. Some of these you should know quite well. I encourage you to sing out and join us. The words are on the screen, or if you'd like to turn into your physical manual. Our first hymn this morning is going to begin for 6:34. Come all Christians, be committed.
Thank you.
It may not be convenient for everyone, but those of us who can, I invite to kneel as we pray. Father in heaven, we are delighted to be able to approach you in prayer, thankful for the freedom that we enjoy, the friendships we enjoy where we're meeting together today, the hope we have, the message we have to share with others, the understanding that gives us a meaning in life. But even as we tell you all that, we're aware that we're very human, and we're aware of time and opportunities wasted this week, of people we didn't help, of people we hurt, of times we didn't act the way Jesus would have. At least it's comforting to remember that the psalmist reminds us that if you kept track of our sins, who could survive? But there's forgiveness with you, and we thank you for that encouragement, that assurance, that reminder that we need to learn from our mistakes and go on and benefit others with our learning. We're also reminded that our world is kind of small. There are a lot of people out there who are hurting. Our bulletin lists a lot of people who have health needs. George Nordling, we need to add to the list, was undergoing some testing, including heart testing. We're aware there is a lot of pain and suffering, and we ask that you work in the way that is best, that you work in maybe through us, to bring help to people where we can. We know we have to rely on you for a lot, but may we be helping in answering our prayers. May we sense that these people maybe could use a phone call or a visit or financial aid or just friendship. And as we enjoy the music today, as we enjoy fellowshipping together, may we remember that it's for helping us become better people, helping the community to be a better community. So it may our time together, may the music we enjoy, the message we hear, all help us to be glad we came, and those around us to be glad we came. May our time together today help us to become more like Jesus and to be more useful in our community. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Our scripture reading is taken from Psalm 42, 1 to 3. I'll be reading from the King James Version because the wording and the music will be using that. As the hart panteth after the water brooks, so panteth my soul after thee, O God. My soul thirsteth for God, for the living God. When shall I come and appear before God? My tears have been my meat day and night, while they continually say unto me, Where is thy God?
Psalm you have read Psalms 42. If you spend time in it, and maybe this is for an older generation, but I know spending time in academy, the song, as the deer panteth for the water, so my soul panteth after thee. It is a positive and uplifting message, and often I feel like we end there and we miss what Psalms 42 is about. I like the contrasting voices of this music that they just sang, because it actually reflects well of what the Psalms was about. It is about David at war with himself. He is talking to his depressed soul, saying, why are you depressed? God is maker of the deep, God is maker of the sea, God is maker of the greatest waterfall, God is maker of everything. And at the end of it, the conclusion is, God says, I am creator of everything, hope in me. Have you ever taken time to stop and reflect on what Jesus suffered on the cross? This last weekend, we celebrated Easter, and I know a lot of families celebrate that in many different ways. For me, I take time with my wife, and we read about the crucifixion, and I take time. I have a nail in my classroom that I often look at over Easter to think about what that must have been like going through hands and feet. I think often if we would have think about the suffering and the pain that Christ did for us and the sheer change in human history and the universe's history for eternity, we wouldn't waste as much time as we do. We wouldn't waste the opportunities that God often sets before us. I encourage you, if you ever have a chance, to look at the sheer poetry and awesome writing that is When I Survey the Wondrous Cross, and reflect on the price that Christ gave for us. It is amazing and astounding. Alleluia is God be praised, and it reminds me of Psalms 9. I will give thanks to the Lord with my whole heart. I will recount all of your wonderful deeds. I will be glad and exult in you. I will sing praise to your name, O Most High. When my enemies turn back, they stumble and perish before your presence. For you have maintained my just cause. You have sat on the throne, giving righteous judgment. You have rebuked the nations. You have made the wicked perish. You have blotted out their name forever and ever. The enemy came to an end in everlasting ruins. Their cities you rooted out. The very memory of them has perished. But the Lord sits enthroned forever. He has established his throne for justice. And he judges the world with righteousness. He judges the peoples with uprightness. The Lord is a stronghold for the oppressed, a stronghold in times of trouble. And those who know your name put their trust in you. For you, O Lord, have not forsaken those who seek you. Sing praises to the Lord who sits enthroned in Zion. Tell among the peoples his deeds. For he who avenges blood is mindful of them. He does not forget the cry of the afflicted. Be gracious to me, O Lord. And remember to let us sing always, Alleluia. Every time I hear that song, it reminds me of Revelation 21, when it describes when all this mess is over and Jesus brings us home. It says, "Behold, the dwelling place of God himself will be with them as their God. He will wipe away every tear from their eyes, and death shall be no more. Neither shall there be mourning, nor crying, nor pain anymore, for the former things have passed away." And he who was seated on the throne said, "Behold, I am making all things new." And we can at last say we are home.
We're gonna ride the chariot in the morning, Lord. Ride the chariot in the morning, Lord. I'm getting ready for the judgment day, my Lord, my Lord. Ride the chariot in the morning, Lord. Ride the chariot in the morning, Lord. I'm getting ready for the judgment day, my Lord, my Lord.
Are you ready, my brother?
Taken up to heaven in 2 Kings 2. It also reminds us of a spirit that was often missed in American history, but one that longed and hoped for liberation. When I listen to songs like this, it reminds me to be grateful and happy no matter the circumstance. When you read this story about Elijah being taken up to heaven, it's interesting that one of the most powerful and memorable songs is tucked away in a short, small segment of Scripture. And it's also interesting, Elisha, after seeing this, tears his garments. And that's also seen as a bad thing, but actually, it's seen as two things. Elisha was signifying that he was missing a friend, but he was also signifying that new things were coming. He was taking off the old and putting on the new. Dear Father in heaven, I thank you for these young men and women that shared your music through word and through their instruments. Lord, thank you for blessing us. Thank you for giving us this Sabbath day and this beauty at this church as we look out and look at all your creation. Lord, thank you for dying on the cross for us. Thank you, even though we didn't deserve it. Thank you for loving us, uncomparable. Lord, I ask that you be with us now. Continue to guide and direct and heal. Wrap your arms around us and help us to remember to celebrate you in your name.